Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will discuss divisions found in many businesses with an emphasis on R&D, research and development. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to list common components of any business, recognize the role of drug discovery within a pharmaceutical company, and connect drug discovery to other roles in pharma. On the screen is a big circle that's supposed to represent a company. And then there are the parts of the company, the pie wedges, personnel, the physical facilities of the company, research and development, production, supply chain management, marketing, sales, regulatory compliance, and legal affairs. Research and development, R&D, is the piece most closely associated with drug discovery and development. Drug discovery and development takes basic scientific research and hopefully translates it into a treatment for a disease in patients. The transition from bench to bedside, as people often say. For a drug company, R&D is the value creation part of the company. Without the other parts of the company, however, R&D, the value creation, is not sustainable. A company needs the right people to perform the R&D, facilities to support research, and all the other aspects of the business to generate revenue, which will in part support future R&D investment. While I think it is clear that R&D has an effect on all parts of a company, R&D is also affected by all other parts of the company to some degree or another. Furthermore, I would argue that in order to understand some of the motivations and decisions that are required in R&D, one must understand factors that affect the other parts of the business. The design of a new drug is affected by regulatory requirements of medications. The design of a drug is affected by legal matters, especially patents as a form of intellectual property. These are just two connections, two influences. Some people would say good science will prevail. I agree, but a pharmaceutical company cannot operate with good science alone. A company also needs marketing, supply chain management, etc. to fully realize its potential. As we work through subsequent videos that generally describe drug discovery and development, keep in mind how research and development are not an isolated part of a pharmaceutical company, but must work within the whole of the operation. This video has merely been an introduction to the idea that businesses are a collection of functioning parts. In a drug company, drug discovery and development is normally the main driver of R&D. To truly understand R&D, we also need to appreciate how all company parts work together to achieve a goal. Thank you for watching to the end of this very brief introduction of how R&D fits within a pharmaceutical company. Please like, subscribe, or leave a comment. Take care.